Hello and welcome. In this video, we will walk through a process of getting through a book or book content that you may not have been able to digest or get through. We're going to use NotebookLM in order to do it. You can start this process with any book that you have not been able to get through. The first step is going to be to get the book into PDF format. You can use any book scanner or book scanning service in order to do it for you. What you'll then have is you'll then have something like a 300-page PDF. And although tempting to upload the whole thing to NotebookLM, that's not what you're going to be doing. What you're going to do is start by printing out each chapter or each half chapter. So what we're going to do here, we're going to determine where each chapter starts and ends. So this chapter starts at page 31. It ends at page 62. So we're going to print out pages 31 to 62. Or pages 31 to 61. We're going to print it as an Adobe PDF. You're going to use whatever PDF printer you have on your personal computer. Yours may not be Adobe PDF. Yours may be Microsoft. It may be Google. But whatever PDF printer that you have, you're going to use it to print just that chapter or just that section and save that section to your hard drive. You will see that that is what I did here. I printed each chapter and each section for me to be able to use. I also have the whole book here, which I'm not going to upload directly to NotebookLM. I'm also not going to undertake this in Gemini. I do want to do this specifically in NotebookLM, even though Gemini is an AI and also by Google. I still want to do this in NotebookLM and not the chatbot. So what you're going to see here is I have all these chapters uploaded as sources to NotebookLM. What I have also done is I've screenshotted my analytics. I've also screenshotted my content and given it all of the information currently inside of my analytics. Now, this may be different for you. Now, if you're not looking at a YouTube channel and you're looking at something else specifically, you want to have information that you want to have analyzed. And what we're doing is we're saying, based on what we're doing, how does that fit within this source that I trust? I'm stating that I trust a specific source. I'm uploading that source chapter by chapter. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask the AI to take my data and analyze it chapter by chapter. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select one chapter, the first chapter. And I'm going to say, analyze my data according to the conclusions in chapter one, pages 20 through 30, however you have it split out. And I'm then going to produce an audio overview, a video overview, a slide deck, and an infographic. And it all really depends on how I learn best. I have personally found that I learn better with a debate than a deep dive. And so I don't want a long debate or short debate. I want a debate, and there's a default link for that. And so when I write in my prompt, all I'm really saying to the AI, I'm not using a secret prompt or anything like that, so I'm not going to give you that. I'm just going to basically say, take my information and analyze it according to chapter 2 of YouTube formula. And I'm going to do that for each individual chapter. As I get these assets, I'm just going to rename them. So if I go in here, I'm going to rename this. Now this is based on chapter 2. And this is the second time around that I've done this with upgraded prompts. I'm going to call this 2B. So that's a 2B infographic. I'm going to do the same thing with a report, right? Because I might learn better by reading this, right? So I might read the analysis. So I'm going to call this a 2B analysis. I'm going to call this a 2B slide deck. Now, you can use whatever naming convention that you want. You don't have to use the one that I'm using. This is an example of how I track it here inside of the studio. And what I can now do, I'm going to do the same thing for a video because I might learn from chapter 2 best from a video. And I'm going to watch all these. And I'm going to do the audio. And again, now this time I did a debate, but I've also done a deep dive with the same chapter. Right, so I'm going to go ahead and do 2B. So I've done this for chapter 2, and I've done all these assets. I'm going to watch them one by one for chapter 2. Once I've done that, I'm going to make sure I understand it. So what I will do is I will take the same prompt that I use. I'm then going to create flashcards. Right, I'm going to do more. I'm going to do hard. I'm going to make sure I understand this. Right, so I'm going to put that in there. And I'm not going to try to fix the prompt or anything like that. I'm just going to use the same one I used to create the asset. I'm going to create flashcards. And I will go through those flashcards for section 2. I will then also do a quiz to make sure I understand it. So I'm going to do same prompt. I'm going to do more questions. I want to make them hard. And I want to click generate. And then I will know that I understand the chapter two, based on my own information and based on conclusions that I can draw myself. So I've tamed this AI to do what I want to do to help me in a specific way that I'm asking it to. I do not want to rely on a secret squirrel prompt specifically. And I would suggest that you not rely on a specific secret squirrel prompt, but that you use your own language. You want to bend this AI to work with you. So when I get the infographic is going to give me specific conclusions based on my data and based on chapter two of YouTube Formula, a source that I trust. I may get slightly different information if I read the PowerPoint presentation, but I'm going to be able to walk through this PowerPoint presentation, and everything really depends on how I learn chapter two best. But I will know chapter two well enough to apply it to my own situation. Once I've gone through all the sources I want to go through, I will then just flip through these flashcards to make sure I understand it. And then I will take the quiz. So now I will thoroughly understand this book when, for years before that, I've never been able to get through this book past chapter one or past chapter two, not because I wasn't interested, but I just could not get through this specific book. So I'm employing NotebookLM to find a way to get this information. And through one of these ways, chapter two's information is going to be accessible to me. It could be some combination of them, or it could be all of them. And then I'll be able to kind of go back and make sure I understand each one. And again, I'm going to name all my assets the same for each one of these. So I'm going to do this and then click enter. And I'm going to name this quiz and click it and make it 002B and then click enter. So I now have a way to, and I'm going to do this through each chapter. Now, this might feel like a slow way to go through a book, and especially in an age of AI when everything's got to be faster, I suggest that you use NotebookLM to go deeper and get an understanding rather than a cursory understanding of something that you find difficult in terms of content. Also, this will allow you to find your trusted sources and then trust your own judgment. I will briefly show you the assets I created for chapter two. So I created an infographic, and this is my own personal infographic. I created a report. So I have a strategic report on what it is I should do just based on chapter two. I also have a slide presentation that I created for chapter two. And again, this is just based on my information as well as the information in chapter two. I have an explainer video that I did. I won't make you watch the entire thing. I'll just skip here to the middle.
Was all about one thing: views. The more clicks, the better, which of course led to an absolute wasteland of clickbait. You'd click a video and it was nothing like the thumbnail, so people would get annoyed and leave.
Okay, so that is part of the analysis for chapter two. And then I also did a deep dive.
Phase of the platform began, and this was the digital gold rush, which immediately preceded the next massive algorithmic adjustment.
And that gold rush was triggered in 2007 with the launch of the partner program.
This was a more historical chapter, but at the end, I've asked that the AI would then take all these conclusions and information and apply it to the data that I have given it about my own YouTube situation. Now, again, if you're not doing YouTube, you would just apply this concept to your own work or your own niche or your own specific job, and then the book that you're trying to apply to your job. And just before I take the quiz, I'm going to go through the flashcards. And then finally, the last thing I'm going to do for chapter two to make sure I understand it, I'm going to take the quiz. And I purposefully made the quiz hard and I've made it long. And so if I understand this well enough, then I'm going to have a thorough understanding of this source that I have said that I trust. Okay, so that thanks, and I will see you in another video.